glory. Give him praise. Exalt his name. Father, we thank you for this brand new week. We thank you for this brand new day. Thank you for your faithfulness. To you alone be all the glory. In the name of Jesus. The God of advancement shall advance you this week. The God that advanced Moses and Aaron shall advance you. This week shall be filled with advancement testimonies for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Please put your hands together for Jesus. And you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. This is our advancement hour. And today, continuing in our series, we've been looking at advancing without tears. And today, I'll be sharing with us what I call advancing by forgetting the negative past. Advancing by forgetting the negative past. I'll quickly read two scriptures and we'll take some lessons this morning before we get our impartation and go and harvest blessings. Philippians chapter 3, 13 and 14. Isaiah 43, 18 to 19. I'll read it too. Philippians chapter 3, 13 to 14. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press towards the mark of the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Isaiah 43. Isaiah 43, I'll read 18 and 19. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Say with me, do it, Lord. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. God will make a way for you in every wilderness. He will make a way for you in the name of Jesus. Precious people of God, you can't travel into the future carrying the tears and regrets of yesterday. Every person in life has a past. But the wise know and understand that you can't dwell in the past to advance into the future. The past is past, and let it be truly past. Never you resurrect the negative past. It will hurt your advancement. Paul said, I forget those things that are behind. Whether you like it or not, there are things that are behind you. There are things in front of you. And I want to let you know that the things that are ahead of you are far greater than the things that are behind you. There's someone hearing me now. Your greatest challenge right now is because of your past you have not allowed to be passed. Maybe you lost opportunities before. Maybe you lost in a business, a relationship. Maybe you lost a loved one. And such things have held you back to the past. You need to allow the past to be past so that you can move forward. I've often said that people who refuse to allow the past to be past will always pass away with the past. I don't think that is our portion. Please hear this. When you soak your today with the worries of the negative past, it has been unconsciously buried to deny you the fruits of tomorrow. I repeat, when you soak your today with the worries of the negative past, you have unconsciously buried your today, thereby denying the fruits of tomorrow. Remember, Today remains the womb of tomorrow. So don't puncture the pregnancy of tomorrow with the poison of the negative past. Don't abort the pregnancy that you are carrying of your future with your negative past. You know what the scripture said? It said, he that puts his hand on the plow and looketh back is not fit for the kingdom of God. Luke chapter 9 verse 62. He that puts his hand to the plow and looketh back is not fit for the kingdom of God. One sure way to remain stagnated, which is a vital enemy of advancement, is to look back. Looking back makes you a statue. Ask lost wife when you see lost wife. There is a scripture. Anytime that scripture comes to mind, it makes me to shock. Luke 17:32, he said, remember lost wife. Three worded scripture. Remember lost wife. What happened to lost wife? Lost wife looked back and became a pillar of sorts. If you want to be stagnated in life, then keep looking back. Precious people of God, it is time for us to deal with our negative past so that it will not deal with our future advancement. Many of us drive. Many of us here, you drive. Now, you agree with me that when you are moving on the highway, you intermittently look at the rear mirror. No driver keeps his focus on the rear mirror. If you do that, you are calling for accident to happen. You cannot drive your life forward looking at the rear mirror of your life. That is an accident going to happen. Doing that will bring accidents. So why are you looking at the negative past? I don't know what your past is like. But somebody has made a mistake yesterday, just like Bishop Abieye will always say. For instance, you wrote an exam, you didn't pass. It was because you made some mistakes. What do? You go and retake. If you miss the taking, what do? You go and retake it. So whatever thing you have missed in the past, may you retake in the name of Jesus. Maybe you made some losses yesterday. You can re-strategize to see how to gain grounds. Stop crying over the speed oil. In my place, they say when oil is speed, you can't get it back. You may not exactly get the oil back, but you can do something. You can productively, you can think, you can creatively create another way out. That is actually what God the Father did. Many of us have read Genesis chapter 1, but that's what God did. In Genesis chapter 1, remember God made the heaven and earth, and the earth became void. There was darkness everywhere. God lost his first business. God lost the first step he took to create a business. But what happened? God did not dwell in the negative past. He didn't keep crying about the past. He has to create a new beginning. He has to create a new world. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. And he brought in what we are enjoying today in the world. The same way, instead of you crying, sitting at the edge of the bed every morning, rehearsing of the negative past, rehearsing of the losses of yesterday, rehearsing of the things that are bringing you pain and hurt. Why not? See, to create a new beginning. Somebody is going to create a new beginning in the name of Jesus. I forget those things that are behind. I press towards the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. You need to forget the past. You need to press into your future. Anyone that will want to advance in life must necessarily do this. Forget ye the former things. Why? I am doing a new thing. May you see the new thing God is about to do in your life. May you experience that new thing in the name of Jesus. Please hear me and hear me well. There are two teachers we have in life. Number one is our school. Our school teaches us, and life also teaches us. The difference between what life teaches us and what the school teaches us is approach. Life will first of all give us tests, and then it's left for you to take lessons from the test or refuse to take lessons from the test And then you keep repeating the class. School will also, school on its own part, will teach you lessons and then bring tests for you. Each one will give you tests. But the difference is that life gives you tests first before you take lessons. But school will give you lessons before you take the test. So, what do you do? Because real life is different from school. That's why some people are passing school, but they can't pass in life. Everything that happened in the past, what you do, draw the lessons as much as you can. And then leave the negative thing and then move forward. Is somebody getting what I'm talking about? That must have happened for a purpose. But many a time we refuse to take the lesson that life wants to teach us, and then we keep repeating the class. That will never be our portion in the name of Jesus. Always learn from the past, forget the negative past, so that you will not be stagnated, so that you will not keep repeating the lesson. Quickly, before my time expires, how to deal with the past in order to advance? I think we need to know this. How do I deal with the past in order to advance? Number one is to have a vision of the future. When you have a vision of your future, you have scored some vital points in overcoming the strings the negative past uses on people. One great cure for the trauma of the negative past is to have a vision of your future. That is why Jesus in Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2, remember, regardless of the cross, regardless of the shame, regardless of all the insult, Jesus despised all of them and went through the cross. He went through the shame because the Bible said there was a joy that was set before him. He could see the throne. He could see where he was going. So what I'm going through now, what the devil may throw at me now, is not relevant. What matters to me is how to get to the future that is set ahead of me. If you can catch a glimpse of your future, you'll be able to despise the negative past. You'll be able to despise the difficulties of the now, so that you can press into that prize of the high calling that is before you. Until you have a vision for your future, your past will keep withdrawing from the joy of the future until it dries it up. I repeat, until you have a vision for your future, the negative past will keep withdrawing from the bank of the joy of your future that is set ahead of you until it dries it up. And listen to me, when joy dries up, everything dries up. Joel chapter 1 verse 12, remember, it says the vine tree dried up, the pomegranate tree, the palm tree, and all the trees of the field are dried up. Why? It says joy has withered from the heart of man. There is a kind of joy your future stirs up inside you. There is a joy that your future set before you. Somebody said, and I believe, he said, depression is the greatest sign of living in the past. Depression is the greatest, sign of living in the past. He said, if you are living in depression, it means you are living in the past. If you are living in anxiety, it means you are living in the future. But if you have peace of mind, it means you are living in the present. If you are living in depression, it means you are living in the past. If you are living with anxiety, you are anxious, that means you are already traveled to the future. Then if you are living in the present, it was shown by the peace of mind. I decree therefore that peace of mind, that peace that passes understanding, that peace that is between the bridge, between the future, the yesterday and the future, I command that peace of mind to flow in your heart in the name of Jesus. I command that peace that Jesus has brought to the world to remain and to flow in your life in the name of Jesus. Number two, how do I handle the past in order to advance? Now, your past is made up of two things. That's why I have to make this statement. So remember the testimonies of the past for your encouragement and your faith. Remember the testimonies of the past. That's why we share testimonies. Remember the testimonies of the past for your encouragement and for your faith. There are certain times nobody will encourage you, just like David. You encourage yourself in the Lord. And one of the things that will make you to do that is to remember the testimonies of the past. So if it's testimony in the past, if it's a great thing God has done, the Bible says you should not forget it. Remember what he said in Psalm 103? He said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. There are things to forget. There are things not to forget. There are things to consider. There are things not to consider. Abraham considered not the deadness of Sarah's womb. There are things to consider. There are things not to consider. There are things to look at. There are things not to look at. For we look not at the things that are seen, but we look at the things that are not seen. For the things that are seen are temporal. They are subject to change. But the things that are not seen are eternal. So you remember the testimonies of the past to encourage you and to build your faith. David said, the God that delivered me from the hand of the lion and the bear, he is also able to deliver me from the hand of this uncircumcised Philistine. And David was able to confront Goliath and advance. Now, if it is negative past, the Bible says, forget the negative past. And why do you forget it? To avoid discouragement. The negative past has a way of discouraging you. Are you sure it will work again? Did I not fail yesterday? Will it work again? Is it not how it happened yesterday? So what? Which is there any way? Let me just remind you where I am. It's okay. So forget the negative past. The Bible said, forget ye the former things, neither consider the things of old. For I do a new thing. Shall you not know it? It shall spring forth. I will make a way in the wilderness, and I will create ways even in the rivers. Now, Isaiah 43, 18 to 19, where we read. So, please, it's important you remember the testimonies of the past for your encouragement. You forget the negative past to avoid discouragement. Well, that is why the psalmist also said in Psalm 42, verse 11, my soul, why art thou cast down within me? Why art thou cast down within me? So, if you keep dwelling in the negative past, your soul will be cast down. And if your soul is cast down, there is nothing you can do. Number three, how do I handle the past to advance? You turn your hearts of the past into harvest for your future. Turn the hearts of the past to harvest. I have what I call turning your hearts into harvest. And I got that secret from Kenneth Copeland. And as a matter of fact, he wrote a book like that, Turning Your Heart to Harvest. Very small book. If you see that book, please read that book. That's where I shared the story of how they stole his camera. Somebody stole his camera. A camera that is dear to him, that's very important for his outreach. And then when they stole the camera, he was so hot. He tried everything. But one day, God told him to turn the heart into harvest. And he decided. How did they do that? He said, okay, anybody that stole this camera, I give it to you as a seed. So God bless me with the harvest. Is somebody getting me now? God bless me with the harvest. And one day he went to a place for another outreach, and he went to a shop, and he saw a camera that is far better and higher in capacity than the one he lost. Naturally, the camera should be sold like $1,000. They were selling it for $100. He asked them, are you sure? They said, that's the price. Are you sure? He said, that's the price. And he was able to buy it. At the end of the day, God made him to understand this is the harvest of what you have lost. So turn your heart to harvest. Let me tell your neighbor, turn your heart to harvest. Somebody may have cheated you. Somebody I met may have, he ran away with your money. He stole your money. Somebody you trained, somebody you helped, somebody you fed. He turned back to bite the hand that fed him. Now, you are really hot. Anytime you remember it, you are really hot. You don't even want to help another person. Please, refuse to dwell in the past. Turn that hot to harvest. Thunder hot. The hot of the losses of opportunity. You're supposed to be promoted. Somebody sat on your promotion. Somebody hid your fire. Somebody denied you that. Turn that hot to harvest. Hallelujah. You know, anytime you remember the hot, you are really pained. You really want to take revenge. But you can turn that hot to harvest. Hear me. The cure of the past is forgiveness. What is the cure of the past? Forgiveness. Both yourself, forgive yourself, forgive others, forgive God if God offended you. Amen. Remember this. Those who look at the past will never see the future. So turn your heart to harvest, and I see God giving you harvest of advancement in the name of Jesus. None of us here today that have had this world will go down in the name of Jesus. The God of advancement that advanced Moses and Aaron shall advance you in the name of Jesus. Wherever you have lost opportunities before, whatever you have lost in a time past that have been bringing hurt to you, I command them to be turned to harvest right now. In the name of Jesus. Opportunities you have lost in the time past, I command multiplied opportunities in other dimensions to appear to you. Contract, jobs you have lost, I decree God is opening new doors for you in the name of Jesus. People that are owing you, they ought to pay you for work you have done, but I see God turning the hearts of soul to harvest of greater blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. Your past shall no longer hold you bound. Every string the past is using to hold you, you want to move, but the past is holding you back. It doesn't want you to advance. I cut that umbilical cord linking you to the past in the name of Jesus. The new thing God has promised to do, may it happen quickly in your life. The things that are before, let them begin to come in the name of Jesus. Rise on your feet this morning. We are going to pray and we are going to receive impartation this morning. Your past will no longer hold you down. We are going to pray this morning. Father, every heart of the negative past, turn it to harvest for me. Everything the past is using to stop my advancement, wherever I've been stagnated because of the negative past, Lord, turn it around. For turn it around. He said you will turn and turn and turn and it will become my turn. Turn it around and advance me in the name of Jesus. Wherever they mocked me because of my past, Lord, use it to move me forward in the name of Jesus. Are you ready to cry to God this morning? Pray from the depth of your heart. I command such umbilical cord to be cut in the name of Jesus. In Jesus, galaba. Every loss in the past, everything that has happened in the past that is bringing sorrow to me today, I decree, Father, let there be a reversal. Let there be a reversal. Turn around my heart. Turn my heart to harvest. 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 Father, my eyes are on you today. Father, advance me as you advance Moses and Aaron. Father, help me to see the things that are before. I know the things that are before are greater than the things that are behind. The things that are before are greater than the things that are behind. Help me, Lord, to see the things that are before. The things that you have set before me. Help me to see them. Help me to experience them. As you advance me, spirit, soul, and body, wherever I am today, let it be the least place I will ever be in life. Jesus, advance me. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Now lift up your two hands to him right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I command by your mighty hand, advance everyone hearing my voice right now. In businesses, in careers, in academies, in ministries, Lord, in the works of their heart, let there be supernatural advancement. I release everyone hearing me now to their next level advancement. Father, whatever is their turnover, whatever is their blessing level right now, let it increase. Favor for advancement comes upon you now. I decree
by the good hand of the Lord. Every back door the enemy is using to siphon your blessing, that back door is closed. Every back door the enemy be using to bring misfortune, delay, disappointment, deniers, I command that back door to be closed. By the good hand of the Lord, I soak you in the favor that makes things to happen. This week is declared a blessed week for you. It declared a week of harvest of blessing. Every step you take this week will land you into fortune. I decree concerning you, you shall enlarge on every side. You shall break forth to the left and to the right. Oh, the Lord God of heaven is changing your position. You will build houses and inhabit them. You will plant and eat thereof. You shall not labor in vain again. The works of your hand shall be blessed. Go and harvest testimonies. Indeed.